young men, some rebels with and without a cause. Their frustration, their anger, or just plain energy are released in different ways.
I'm telling you, you can make whatever kind of money you want to make. You can have whatever you want to have. You can do whatever you want to do. Like, there are no limitations. And aren't you tired? There's some of y'all out there right now. You're tired. You know, somebody telling you when to come to work. Somebody telling you when to take lunch. Somebody telling you when to do a vacation. Somebody telling you what you can and cannot do. Some of us, we were born to fly. But what I'm telling you is, when you become the right person, what I mean by the right person is, once you identify who you are and you begin to separate yourself from the masses, and you begin to see your individuality, when you begin to see your talents, when you begin to see your personal skills, all right, it's like this. If you ever wore a suit from the store before, that's one thing. But if you ever got a suit tailored, are you hearing what I'm saying? If you ever got a tailored suit before, you know that it's different from going to buy a one-size-fits-all suit and then having a suit that's tailor-made. It fit different. The pants are different. The way you walk in it is totally different. Why? Because it's fit to you. And what I'm telling you is, you need to have a tailor-made life. When you were created with a specific purpose, a specific design. I don't care if you was born and, you know, your parents didn't claim you. You still special. I don't care if your mama went in your life, your daddy went in your life, you are still special. When you were created, you were designed to do what nobody else can do. And I'm telling you, when you become the right person, what you do is you start separating yourself from other people. You begin to have a certain uniqueness. As long as you following other people, as long as you being a copycat, you will never ever be the best copycat in the world, but you will be the best you could be. So I'm challenging you, number one.
You don't burn out mentally, because you always burn out physically. The differential of somebody winning and losing has nothing to do with their genetics, has nothing to do with their potential. You're gonna feel this soreness you've never felt before. It's supposed to be that way. It means you're using muscles you haven't used before. Your body's waking up, sharpening your arsenal for perfection of what you can be. But if you didn't know that, mentally, you didn't prepare for that, you think something's wrong, maybe it's time to stop. No, it's time to move even further. Even though you go to the gym, you put your time in there, you check the box, yeah, I went to the gym, man, all good. You come back around, you look in the mirror, man, I'm not seeing any change yet. No. Well, because you haven't pushed yourself for your body to have a reason to change. If I gave a valiant effort to something, day in, day out, I saw no change, I'd probably quit too. When you embark this journey, you must know that it's going to go down before it comes up. And when it comes up, it's going to go so much higher than you've ever been. Sacrificing today for tomorrow. I couldn't hold myself up. Hit the pavement. I'm okay with that. Because tomorrow I'll get back up and do it again. And I'm going to try to beat my last performance in life. It's not the genetic guy who wins, or the guy with the most potential that wins. It's the person with the greatest perseverance that wins. Always willing to get up and go at it again and go at it again. That's the guy who has his hand raised later in life, guys. That's the guy you guys need to be.